I guess you got to start.
What I'd like to do is just make a brief statement, and if you have a couple questions, be glad to answer those. First, let me say that I hate what has happened. I hate it for the teams, the players, the sport, the soccer league of Madison. I hate it for my son. I hate it for everyone that's been affected by this. But I think everybody can understand that as a dad, if there's an out of control coach that's verbally abusing a player, and in particular your son, that it's your duty to try to stop it. And in this case, there was an out of control coach who was yelling and screaming in a verbally abusive way to my son's team and to my son. It scared him and it hurt him. And as a dad, I wanted to protect him. And so I approached Mr. Hester, and I said one thing and one thing only: never speak to my son that way again. And at that point, he lost control, just as he was out of control after the game with my son and team. He became out of control, left his car, attacked me. I acted in self-defense and restrained him. And as we go forward in this process, the facts and the truth and the witnesses will show that. And so I'm looking forward to the process as it goes forward, so that those facts can be known and the witnesses will corroborate what I'm saying. But having said all of that, what is the best way to move forward? And I think as adults trying to set examples for the boys, if Mr. Hester and I could sit down, resolve this, move on, it would be the best example and the best way to approach that. I was willing to do that from the beginning, and I'm still willing to do that. And I hope that's something that as we go forward in this process, that we'll have a chance to do.
In hindsight, do you feel like you could have handled the situation better?
I wish that it was obvious that Mr. Hester was very angry at the end of the game and that was very agitated. I wish I had not said anything to him now. But I was saying something because I felt like I needed to protect my son. And what I said was completely appropriate: never speak to my son again. And that's all I said. And so I think any parent can understand that. But because he was so agitated and angry, I wish that I had not approached him and said anything.
What about his allegation that you basically pulled him out of the car and attacked him while he's wearing a neck brace?
Yeah. That is simply not true, and the witnesses will verify that I approached the car. He left the car. He undid his seatbelt, opened the car door, came out, then immediately went on the attack, swinging. Hit me. I restrained him, and then we were separated. He continued to try to attack me after we were separated, and was continually yelling as I tried to walk away from the incident.
Where did he
attack
you? Where
did he hit you? He hit me behind my right ear. Excuse me, my left ear, but this. What the facts will show. Yes, and what the facts will show is that he left his car. Mm-hmm. He attacked me. I restrained him. We were separated, and I just the whole thing. I hate that it happened.
Did you ever think it would go this far?
No, when I approached him, the last thing I ever thought. That this would escalate into what happened, but it was obvious that he was he was already angry. His team had lost two games. He didn't feel like the officials or the play was what it should have been. He was angry at what was horseplay at the end of the game that he interpreted as something else. He began to yell at my son, "You're pathetic. You should be ashamed." And he repeatedly yelled and screamed, "You're pathetic and you're ashamed. You should be ashamed." And so that's, that's what happened.
What started the whole thing? why did he go to your son instead of
my son had a friend on the other team who he knows very well. Mm-hmm. And at the end of the game, he jumped on his back in what was playfulness for him. But I think Coach Hester interpreted it as bad sportsmanship. And that so he became angry about that. And so that's what led to Coach Hester yelling at my son in the manner that he did. I think that's, I think that covers everything. And
I have one quick question. A moment ago you said that you hoped that the two of you could sit down and talk about this. Do you mean that you're hoping that you can reach some type of agreement before it goes to court, or?
I'm willing to sit down with Mr. Hester at any point, any place, resolve this, shake hands, and set a good example for the kids on the teams and the soccer leagues. And so the night of the incident, I was willing to do so. I have been since. I will be willing to do so in the future.
How likely is that to happen after the situation is quickly getting populated with lawyers?
Yeah.
What
I would like it, instead of lawyer to lawyer, I'd like it to be man to man. Shake hands and move on. I think that it would be better for everyone. I think all adults, all parents would say, as adults, we need to set good examples. This type of conflict is not good for anybody. And so I hope that we can resolve this in a way that sets a good example from a very bad situation.
Mr. Pickering, I have a few more questions. You're no longer a U.S. congressman, but people still see you as a public figure, and a lot of people look up to you. What do you have to say to people that you've been down, so to speak?
Part of the price of being a former public official is that you do need to set a good example. And what I want to do, I'm not sorry that I protected my son. I'm not sorry that there was an out-of-control coach who was verbally abusing players and my son, to say, don't do that again. And that's all I did. That's all that I intended to do. But at this point, the second thing as a good example is that when something like this happens, is that you try to sit down and resolve and reconcile and then move forward. And that's what I hope can happen here. I don't think that I would be here today if I weren't a former public official, and I don't think that you would be here, and that's part of the price of being a former public official. What I hope to do is to handle this in a way. I wanted to protect my son. I wanted to stop somebody from verbally abusing, and I still want to do that, but I want to now find a way to resolve this between Mr. Hester and me in a good way.
Mm-hmm.